When we think of quiche art, we think of gaudy works, quirky, exaggerated, something that can be mass-produced or designed using cultural icons. An example of today's quiche art would be Jeff Koons, Michael Jackson, and Bubbles. Michael Jackson was supposed to have been a huge fan of quiche art, and he had several paintings and sculptures done of himself. For example, we see David Nordahl's Michael Jackson is David with cherubs here, which is a knockoff of Michelangelo's David, and we see the cherubs and of course the resemblance of Michael Jackson. Another example of today's quiche art would be this painting by Kelly O, which is called Dog Painting. She combines Van Gogh's Starry Night with American Gothic, with paintings of her very own dogs. Quirky, sentimental, yes, it can be mass-produced. Here's another classic piece of quiche art from today, dogs playing poker, where you see different breeds of dogs all playing poker and smoking and drinking, and even looks like the bulldog is cheating with the card under the table. Frivolous, not necessarily gaudy, but definitely mass-produced. And then we are asked to consider whether the works of the Pre-Raphaelites, Hogarth, and Grüssy, would they be considered quiche art if painted today? And the Pre-Raphaelites were founded under the principle of moral reform realism, depicting truth and accuracy. They had fine detail in their painting. Here we see William Holman Hunt's Our English Coast, which depicts the sheep in their natural setting on a hillside. It's a beautiful painting. It's real. I would have to say that this would not be considered, in my opinion, a piece of quiche art if painted today. And here we see William Hogarth's Marriage a la Mode, The Marriage Settlement. And William Hogarth was a social critic and a cartoonist, and this painting was actually number one in a series of six. And it tells the story of an arranged marriage between a rich merchant and an earl, and we see the earl's daughter. You know, the series continues on. We see the painting of, you know, the daughter actually had an affair and the death of her lover. So with this series and in this standalone piece, I can see this as a piece of quiche art because it is quirky, not necessarily gaudy, but tells a story, but it's humorous. It's if you think in terms of a cartoon strip, you can see that mass produced. So this one I definitely like. And in this painting by Jean-Baptiste Greuze, Wicked Son Punished, while it is very sentimental and melodramatic, we have to consider whether this would do well as a mass-produced piece, and I don't think that this would work well. So this is my presentation. Thank you very much for listening.